Hi, my name's Antony, I work here at Melett's technical team. Welcome to our latest Turbo Tips video. What we're going to discuss today is oil contamination, one of the main reasons that turbochargers fail. So, what is oil contamination? Oil contamination, put simply, is when the oil that flows from the turbocharger is contaminated. What we're going to focus on today are some of the causes, signs and preventions associated with oil contamination. So first up is causes. What causes oil contamination? We picked out a few here, but there are many more in our help guides. One of them is poor quality or a damaged oil filter. Any carbon buildup or swarf deposits from the engine, carbon from the oil feed pipe, or any shot from the reman process if you have bought a remanufactured turbocharger. When a turbocharger fails from oil contamination, it leaves signs. First of all, we're going to look at the shaft and wheel to see what kind of signs oil contamination leaves. If the oil is contaminated, there will be score marks on the journal bearing landing areas, as you can see here. There are different levels of damage. Here we have an extreme case of oil contamination and the damage it's caused. Again, the landing area is the area that is most affected. Even though this is a fixed journal bearing application, you can still see the damage that has been caused by oil contamination. The next component that we would look at is the journal bearing. On the journal bearing, what we would look at here is the OD and the ID to check for any scoring. On a free floating bearing, the ID and the OD will be scored. On a fixed journal bearing, it will usually just be the ID that's scored on that. Here are the effects oil contamination has on a free floating journal bearing. What we've done here is we've cut a bearing in half to try and show you exactly what the score marks look like on the ID of the journal bearing. Another key area where you'll find signs of oil contamination is on the thrust bearing. This will be mainly on the ramping because this is where the majority of the oil flows around the thrust setup. What we'll do now is we'll take a closer look at the ramping area and see the score marks around the ramping that will identify that the failure is oil contamination. There will be different levels of damage caused by oil contamination. Here we're using a severe case of scoring to highlight the damage caused to the thrust bearing. Along with the thrust bearing, the thrust flinger, washer and collar will show signs of oil contamination. What we'll do now is we'll take a look at these three components in closer detail. So we've discussed the causes and looked at the signs. And last but not least, we're going to look at prevention. We've picked out a few examples, but for any more information, look at our help guide on our website. There is a downloadable PDF which you can pin up around your workshop. First up, check your engine for any signs of swarf deposits. Take care when you're changing the engine oil and always use the recommended oil and oil filters. Change or clean any oil feed pipes or any oil return pipes that you're going to attach, and that should help you have a longer lasting turbocharger. What we like to do here at Melett is we like to give you a turbo tip. Our turbo tip around oil contamination is always make sure you diagnose the original cause of failure. If the original cause of failure was oil contamination and you don't diagnose that properly, it will end up in catastrophic failure when you refit the turbocharger. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time with more Melett's technical turbo tip videos. If you've enjoyed what you've seen today, hit like, comment below, or subscribe to our YouTube channel to watch further Melett videos.